Hello students, good morning to all. Welcome back to our online session. Today we are at the end of our second unit, and in this session we will see the difference between homogeneous distributed database system and heterogeneous distributed database system. After that, difference between distributed database and parallel database. And the last one point is that difference between centralized and distributed database system. After that, we will revise the whole topic. In short, this is about today's session. Now, let's start with the first point, that is the difference between homogeneous distributed database system and heterogeneous distributed database system. The first one difference, you all know what is homogeneous and what is heterogeneous distributed database system. The first one point is that in homogeneous distributed database, all the sites use identical database management system and operating systems. Opposite to that, in heterogeneous distributed database, different sites have different operating systems, database management system product and database data models. The second one difference is that in homogeneous distributed database, the sites use very similar software, and in heterogeneous distributed database, different sites use dissimilar schemas and software. The next one difference is that in homogeneous distributed database system, the sites use identical database management system or database management system from the same vendor. And in heterogeneous distributed database system, the system may be composed of variety of database management systems like relational, network, hierarchical or object oriented. And the last one difference is that in homogeneous distributed database system, database is an Oracle database, and in heterogeneous distributed database system, at least one of the database is non-Oracle database. Now, we will see the difference between distributed database and parallel database system. In various terms, they are differentiated. Like definition, location, execution speed, node types, performance, scope of expansion, backup, consistency. These are the various terms used for differentiate the distributed database and parallel database system. Now, first of all, we will see the definition of parallel database system. That parallel database system, it is the software system where multiple processors or machines are used to execute and run queries in parallel. And distributed database system, it is a software system that manages multiple logically interrelated databases distributed over a computer network. The second one difference is related to the location, where parallel database system and where distributed database system is located. As you know, the nodes in the parallel database system are located at the same location, and the nodes in the distributed database system are located at the different locations. Now, execution speed. We will see the execution speed. In parallel database system, execution speed is faster, and in distributed database system, execution speed is slower than the parallel database system. Next one difference is related to the node type. In parallel database system, the node types compulsorily homogeneous. But in distributed database system, there is no need the homogeneous. The node types may be heterogeneous. Now, what is the performance in parallel database system? There is a lower reliability and availability, but opposite to that, in distributed database system, there is a higher reliability and availability. The scope of expansion, that is in parallel database system, it is difficult to expand, but distributed database system is easier to expand. The next difference is related to the backup. In parallel database system, backup is at one site only, but in distributed database system, backup is at multiple sites. And the last one is consistency. Maintaining consistency is easier and simpler in parallel database system, and maintaining the consistency is difficult in distributed database system. This is all about the difference between distributed database system and parallel database system. Now we will see the last point of our second unit, that is the difference between centralized database and distributed database system. We all know what is centralized database system and what is parallel database system. Centralized database system is nothing but if the data is stored at a single computer site which can be used by multiple users, then it is said to be centralized database system. And the database and database management system software distributed over many sites connected by a computer network, then it is called as a parallel database system. Here we see in the definitions of both the systems. Now the second one difference is that centralized database system achieves efficiency through local optimization by using complex physical data structure. But parallel database system, it achieves efficiency through global optimization of processing, including cost of network communication and local processing. Now, in centralized database system, database is maintained at only one site, but in parallel database system, database is maintained at a number of different sites. The next one difference is that you all know it very well. If centralized database system fails, then entire system gets failed. And in parallel system, if one system fails, system continues work with other site. And the last one difference is that centralized database system is less reliable and parallel database system is more reliable. This is all about the differences between different points. Now, I would like to revise all the points from second unit. In short, the unit name is data models and database types. In this, our goal is to achieve the second course outcome, that is choose relevant data model to solve a problem. By completing this unit, you all are able to choose relevant data model to solve a problem. That is nothing but achieving the second course outcome. After that, unit outcome. After completing this unit, you all are able to achieve these four unit outcomes, that is you all are able to explain the efficiency and storage complexity of the given data model. Then the second one outcome is you all are able to explain the merits and drawbacks of the given data model. You all are able to convert a given hierarchical database to relational database, that is tree structure to the table structure. And the last one is that to represent a data set in a given data model graphically. If you all are able to do these outcomes, then you successfully get this chapter. Then we see in these contents, like first one is database model. As you know, a database model defines logical design and structure of database and defines how data will be stored, accessed and updated in the database management system. Database model is nothing but it is a structure or a format of database. There are three types: object-based data model, physical data model and record-based data model. The classification is as shown in figure. Data model is classified into three types: object-based, record-based, and physical data model. After that, object-based data model having two types, entity relationship model and object-oriented model. And record-based data model contains relational model, network model and hierarchical model. Now, what is object-based logical model? It describes data at the conceptual and view level. It contains ER model and object-oriented model. Record-based logical model is nothing but it describes data at the conceptual and view level. These models specify logical structure of database with record, field and attributes. It contains different data models, hierarchical, relational and network model. And the last one is physical data model describes data at the lowest level of abstraction. In our syllabus, the detailed study of hierarchical database model, network database model, relational database model and object-oriented database model is included. The first one is that hierarchical database model. This was developed by IBM for IMS, that is Information Management System. Hierarchical database model, the name suggests that it organizes data into tree-like structure with a single root to which all other data is linked. The hierarchy starts from the root data and expands like a tree, adding child nodes to the parent node. In this model, a child node will only have a single parent node and it includes one-to-many relationship. This is one example of hierarchical database model. That college is nothing but root, after that department and infrastructure are the parents. And in department, there are three classification: course, teachers, students. These are the childs of that parent department. After that, we have seen that advantages of hierarchical database model. It allows easy addition, deletion of new information. Data at the top of hierarchy is very fast to access. It relates well to anything that works through one-to-many relationships. It was very easy to work with this model. These are the advantages, and after that we had seen the disadvantages of hierarchical database model, that it requires data to be repetitively stored in many different entities. We no longer use linear data storage mediums such as tapes, so that advantage is null. Clever manipulation of data model are required to make many relationships. The disadvantages like inflexibility, no standards, implementation complexity, then operation anomalies, poor portability are disadvantages of hierarchical database model. Here, example of hierarchical database model that you already know that example. Next one is network database model, introduced by Charles Bachman in 1969. It is the extension of the hierarchical model, one step ahead to the hierarchical model. In this model, data is organized more like a graph and are allowed to have more than one parent node. Remember one thing, in hierarchical database model, there is only one parent node for childs, and in network database model, there are multiple parents to the childs. In this, it supports many-to-many data relationships. Here is the example of network database model that CSE department having, student node having two parents, that is CSE department and library. But it is not possible in the hierarchical model, that's why network database model gets introduced. Now, advantages of network database model. Related to the, it supports high speed, simplicity, ability to handle more relationship types, that is one to many and many to many relationship, ease of data access, data integrity, data independence are the advantages of network database model. And disadvantages are system complexity, lack of structural independence and alternations, difficulty. These are the disadvantages. Next, the difference between hierarchical and network model. As it's a hierarchical database model supports one to many, network supports many to many relationship. Related to the navigability, flexibility, as hierarchical model use pointers to relate data, and network model use links to relate data. Hierarchical is tree like structure, and network is based on records and links. These are the differences between hierarchical and network database model. After that, we have seen the object oriented database model. This model is around mid 1970s. When the concept of object oriented programming was first explored, then the object oriented data model gets explored. Then the object oriented data model is based on the collection of objects. In this model, two or more objects are connected through links. We use this link to relate an object to other object. This is the example of object oriented database model. Then advantages of object-oriented database model are related to reduced maintenance, real-world modeling, improved reliability and flexibility, high code reusability, improved performance. These are the advantages. And disadvantages are related to the lack of universal data model, lack of experience, competition, complexity, lack of support for security. Then we started relational database model proposed by Edgar F. Codd to model data in the form of relations or tables. Relational database model was used. Relational database model represents database as a collection of tables. The table is a database object that stores data in the form of rows and columns. Each row in the table represents collection of related data value. In that, various terms like relations, tuple, attribute, domain. Relation is two-dimensional table, that is information arranged in rows and columns is nothing but relation. Here you can see the table that is called as a relation. Next one term is tuple. It is nothing but a single row of table which contains a single record for that relation, that is 1, 2, 3, Google, Amazon, Apple, status, active, active, inactive. These are the tuple. The related term to the tuple is cardinality. Cardinality is nothing but total number of rows present in the table. Here cardinality of table is 3, that is total number of rows. Now attributes, column header is called as a attribute, that is customer ID, customer name, status is the attribute. Attributes are the properties which define a relation. The term related to the attribute is degree. The total number of attributes which in the relation is called as a degree of the relation. Here degree is 3, that is total number of column. Now domain, all permissible value of attribute is called as a domain, or it is the set of values of the same data types. Like customer ID is any 4-digit number, customer name is in string, status is in string, that is called as a domain. Here you can see the student relation in relational model, where you are able to show attributes, field, tuple, cardinality, degree and student relation. Now advantages of relational database model are simplicity, structural independence is there, easy to use, query capability, data independence, scalability. And disadvantages are sometimes it becomes complex. It leads to the isolated database where the information cannot be shared from one system to another. After that, we had seen comparison between hierarchical database model, network database model and relational database model. Next, and the last point of this unit is that types of database system, that is centralized database system, parallel database system, client server database system and distributed database system. In centralized database system, it is nothing but it is a type of database that stores data at the centralized database system. It conforms the users to access the stored data from different locations through several applications. This database system, which is located, maintained and stored in a single location such as a mainframe computer. Example is the central library that carries the central database of each library in a college or university. Here you can see the example of centralized database system. After that, advantages, like it has decreased the risk of data management, that is manipulation of data will not affect the core data, provides better data quality, consistency, data consistency is maintained, then provides high level security. Then disadvantages of centralized database system are, it is not easy to update such an extensive database system. The size is large, which increases response time for fetching the data. While using centralized database system, responsibility of local manager will be reduced, and we have to spend more money to manage and store the data. These are the disadvantages. Next one is parallel database system, which improves performance of data processing using multiple resources in parallel, like multiple CPUs and disk are used parallelly. It also performs many parallelization operations like data loading and query processing. Here you can see the example of parallel database system. For what purpose parallel database system is designed? Improve performance, to improve availability of data, to improve reliability, and to provide distributed access of data. Now the advantages are speed, reliability, and capacity. And disadvantages of parallel database are power consumption is huge and initial cost is so high. Now the client server database system, which can be categorized according to the unit of interaction among client and server process. You all know about the client, what is client and what is server. Client can send data request to the server, and server provides service to the client's request. Three types of client server architectures are there: single tier client server computing models, two tier client server computing model, and three tier client server computing model. The problems overcome in one tier, sorry, the problems came in one tier are overcome in two tier architecture, and the problems arise in two tier are solved in the three tier architecture. That's why most commonly used architecture is that three tier architecture is used, that is client server, three tier client server architecture is used for client server database model, database system, in which the client, that is the data capture and validation tier, is known as the client. The second level is application server, which is middle tier, and the third one phase is database server, in which data storage is done. Now what are the advantages? It has less expensive platform, then more flexible, response time and throughput is high, graphical menu driven interface is there, then it provides more productive work by the users and efficient use of existing data. Next, disadvantages are programming cost is high, and there is a lack of management tools for diagnosis, performance monitoring, and tuning and security control. The next one is distributed database system. That distributed database system is nothing but, it consists of two or more files located in different sites, either on the same network or an entirely different network. It allows application to access data from local and remote database. Here you can see the distributed database system, where different locations are connected to the communication channel, having their own memory and database. The classification is likewise, distributed database is classified into two types, homogeneous and heterogeneous. Homogeneous is nothing but all different sites store database identically. Here Oracle 9i is used for all different sites. Next, there are two types of homogeneous, autonomous and non-autonomous. Autonomous is nothing but each database is independent that functions on its own, And non-autonomous is nothing but data is distributed across the homogeneous node and a central or master database management system coordinates data updates across the sites. Now heterogeneous database, second type of distributed database system in which different sites can use different schema and software that can lead a problem to problem in query processing and transactions. Here you can see the heterogeneous database system in which different sites having different databases like SQL Server 2009, Oracle 9i, MS Access, which are connected via communication channel. And there are again two types of heterogeneous distributed database, that is federated and unfederated. Federated database system is the heterogeneous database system are independent in nature and integrated together so that they function as a single database system. And unfederated, the database system employs a central coordinating model through which the database are accessed. There are various advantages of distributed database system like transparency, improved performance, reliability through distributed transaction, easier system expansion, independence is there, continuous operations, modularity and local autonomy. And again there are disadvantages like recover from failure and synchronization is difficult, increased storage and infrastructure is required, design issues are there, cost of update replication is more, cost of security constraints is more, distributed access to data and additional softwares are required in distributed database system. Difference between homogeneous heterogeneous, as I told earlier. Then difference between distributed database and parallel database system. And the last one is difference between centralized database and distributed database system. This is about the second unit. In the next session, we will meet with the new unit. Thank you. Thank you so much.